Hi, I'm Alan, and I work at State Library Victoria with the Library Systems and Digital Preservation team. My team manages a lot of the digital magic you see reflected in the amazing online resources the library offers. We're going to talk today about creating online digital jigsaw puzzles that you can work yourself or can share with friends and family. Doing this is super easy. The key to making them is this magic puzzle cookie cutter image. Put your picture on the left and a web browser on the right. Warm up a bit, then just toss the picture through the cookie cutters, and there you go, all done. Well, actually, there's a little more to it than that, but it is super easy. There are a number of sites online that allow you to create your own jigsaw puzzles. Each site has things it does well and things it's not so good at. Personally, I like Jigsaw Explorer. I like the options it gives for creating pictures, the ease of working the puzzle, and the quality of the puzzles created. Your first task is to select a picture to use. Jigsaw Explorer has one important limitation for what pictures you can use if you want to share your puzzle with others. They must be posted on the internet somewhere, and the URL or address must indicate the format of the image. This means that you can't create a puzzle using a picture from your computer or phone directly. But that's not really a limitation, because you can take any photo you want, post it on social media such as Facebook, Instagram, Flickr, any others, and then you can use it from there to create your puzzle. As you select a picture, think about your audience, that is, who will work the puzzle. If it's just for your own entertainment, you might want a cherished family picture. If it's for a child, you'll want to select a picture with lots of contrast, probably lots of color, and an interesting subject. For a veteran jigsaw puzzle fan, you can select a more difficult picture, such as one with a lot of solid background, or one with hundreds of marbles, or leaves. One great source for pictures is State Library Victoria's digitized photo collection, particularly the 200,000 or more in the digital image pool. Photos, drawings, maps, and papers available for you to use without copyright restrictions. Unfortunately, these pictures have URLs or addresses that don't indicate what format the images are, such as JPEG, GIF, or PNG. So they can't be used directly. However, you can always post one to your social media sites or find one on one of the library's excellent blog posts and use them from there. That's what I'm going to do for this video. Finally, make sure you have the right to use the picture. Your own pictures and many of the images in the State Library's catalog can be used. However, there may be conditions of use, such as acknowledging the photographer or artist and crediting the library. Look at any information on the site where you get your photos to see if there are specific conditions, then abide by those conditions when you create your puzzle. Let's go through the process of creating your puzzle on Jigsaw Explorer. When you have selected and possibly posted an image to use, right-click on it and select Copy Image Address. You don't want to copy the image, just the address. What you see in your browser might be slightly different, but this should give you a good idea of what to look for. On the Jigsaw Explorer site, jigsawexplorer.com, scroll down a bit and click on Create Your Own Custom Puzzle. You could also play a puzzle with an image from your computer, but then you can't share it with others. So go with Create Your Own Custom Puzzle. The first field to fill in is for the image URL. The address that you copied a moment ago. Paste that into the URL field. Somewhere in the address, possibly at the end, there should be .jpg, .gif, or .png, any of which indicate the format of the image. If the URL does not indicate the image format like this, Jigsaw Explorer will fail in creating a puzzle. There are other fields to fill in after the URL. You can fill in a credit line and, optionally, a credit URL. If the image you're using has conditions of use, such as the requirement that you acknowledge the creator or the state library or some other source, This is where you enter that. If you are using your own photo, you can fill these in or leave them blank. Below these fields is a place to select the number of pieces you want for your puzzle. The default is 100, but set the number based on who will be working the puzzle. Then select a contrasting background color for your puzzle. You're ready to click the Create button. Jigsaw Explorer will create your puzzle and give you both a long and a short URL. Copy the short one and keep track of it, so you can go back to this puzzle whenever you want, or you can share it with friends. There's a link beside the short URL to try it. Click on that to work the puzzle yourself. When you first open your puzzle, there's a little options menu in the middle. The three main options are the number of pieces, rotation, and background. If you've created a puzzle with 100 pieces, but someone who is working it wants to try it with 150 pieces, they can change the number before they start to work the puzzle. For a child or a novice, you can also change to a smaller number of pieces. When you start, pieces are right side up. If you want a harder puzzle, click to rotate the pieces, which you'll have to correct one by one. Finally, you can choose a different background color than you did in creating the puzzle. Once you click the OK button, the menu disappears, but you can get it back by clicking on the three lines in the upper left and selecting Modify this puzzle. To work the puzzle, hover over a piece, click and hold, then drag the piece where you want it to go. If you have rotated the pieces, use your mouse's scroll wheel to rotate them back. Scroll down for clockwise or up for anticlockwise. If you don't have a scroll wheel, don't choose to rotate the pieces because there's no other way to get them back. If you drop a piece in exactly the spot where it needs to join to one or more other pieces, the two pieces will click together. You can be off by a little bit, but not too far. The dotted line icon in the top menu makes all of the non-edge pieces disappear, or reappear. The picture icon on the right shows you the image that you started with. Hover to see it, or click to make it stay. It can get a bit confusing to have it there all the time, though. When I was growing up, the rule in our family was that you could look at the picture on the box cover before you started working on the puzzle, but once you started, you couldn't look again until the puzzle was completed. But you may have a different rule. All that's left at this point is to play the puzzle, which is the fun part. Do the edges first, move pieces around or sort them, rotate them until they look right, look at the picture, drag and drop pieces so they click together, or whatever works for you in completing the puzzle. When you complete it, Jigsaw Explorer will give you the adulation that you deserve. So, using these instructions, go make your own jigsaw puzzles and earn that praise.